So now I must write down the properties of beta function. So the first property is basically nothing but the relation between beta function and gamma function. Okay, the first property is the relation between beta function and gamma functions. Okay. So the first property says that beta mn is nothing but basically gamma m into gamma n upon gamma m plus n. So this is the very first property of beta function, which is the relation between beta function and gamma function. And the second property is says that beta half comma half means beta m n means the value of m is also half, the value of m is half, and the value of n is also half. So when there is a value of beta half and half, so you just put this one, put this one in this relation, so you get gamma m means gamma half means gamma half plus gamma half plus half, right? So you already know the value of gamma half is root pi, and the value of gamma 1 is 1. So from where is the gamma 1 coming? See, gamma half plus half, so gamma 1, the value of gamma 1 is 1 means the denominator is 1. So value of gamma half is root pi, so root pi into root pi, it's pi. So means we can say the value of beta half and half is only pi. Okay. Root pi into root pi is pi. So the value of beta half half is basically pi. So these two are the main properties of beta function, which we will be using in our successive problems, right?